Welcome once again to your vocabulary class, where in the previous class we have completed these two. The main criteria is that, like, main explanation part is how to improve your vocabulary. So in the particular heading, how to improve your vocabulary, we have 4 points, and among these 4 we have completed 2 already in the previous class. Now we are going to start with the 3rd point, that is use of prefixes and suffixes. Use of prefix: prefix, pre, before; fix, fixing the word before the main word, that is prefix, before fixing. Okay, so prefix, placed before root word. Separate it out, you can get it very easily. I hope you have heard about quick fix and all adhesives in the same way. Prefix: pre, before, and fixing. Fix is fixing. So placed before root word, main root word. In the previous class we have got the explanation of the root word. Here is the how to add those. And remember one thing, that the prefixes or suffixes could change the meaning, but the main root word would be always there. Only we have to either add in front or to add at the end. That makes a difference, but main original word would be there, the root word would be always there. Like pre-final, if what does I mean actually, what do I want to say here is that pre, if we remove pre, final is a word or not? Yes, final itself is a word. We are adding something to make it pre-final. Pre-final exams being conducted in schools, colleges, everywhere. Why? Just before the final. So what we are adding here, we are adding a prefix of pre. Okay, next is bicycle. Cycle itself is a word and we are adding it to make it bicycle. Now here is multinational. Multi, many. Bi means two. Here multi, many, many nationalities, multinational companies in many nations or many countries in the world, they have their company, that is known as MNC, multinational companies, which have the companies in other countries as well, not only in one country. Okay, multinational, multilingual, knowing many languages, can speak many languages. Multiplex, a complex being changed into a multiplex, means where you can get many things into one of the complex, that is multiplex. So where we are adding here the prefixes to make the meaning more concise. Next is like rebirth, birth, rebirth. Replace, I have made it separate to make you understand, otherwise we can use without a hyphen. Replace, replacing the bag, replacing the pen, replacing the person, that can be a replace. Next is restore, restore, again keeping at the same place, restore, that is restore. Okay, these are the prefixes. Now we'll go for the use of suffixes, added at the end of the word. These words would be added at the end of the root word to make a new word. Social plus ism, socialism. Okay, so what we are adding here, ism, socialism. Chronology, I have taken this example one more time to remind you, we have already read this in the root word. So root is here, we are adding logy, study of. Okay, time, study of time. So we are adding to the main word, to the root word. Childish, child itself is a word and we are adding ish to make it a foolish, like brandish. This type of the words can be you, means like get the suffixes of ish when we are using the root word as well as we are adding the another word to make it a new word and this another one is the suffix. Careless, you know very well, careful, careless, all comes under the your suffixes. Care itself is a root word. We are adding careless, less, or careful. So these are the suffixes. But you have to be very careful. Sometimes the root word get a little bit changed, like as I said here, plex. In the same way, sometimes root word can get changed a little bit, but the overall main word to be as it is, and then you have to add the suffixes. Here in prefixes, we are adding in front of the word. In suffixes, we are adding at the back of the or at the end of the word, main word, we are adding something to make it a different meaning. Okay, so this is actually uses of prefixes and suffixes. With these you can able to add more words into your vocabulary. Like you can understand very easily multinational, immediately you understood that, okay, as I said, multilingual, replace, rebirth. With that words you can improve your vocabulary, and you can there is no need for you to say for taking birth again, it's rebirth. Place other thing at the same place or same area instead of replace, you are replacing that. So if you know all the prefixes and suffixes, at least some of them, then it will be very easier for you to improve your vocabulary and to use new words into your language, which obviously increase or enhances your fluency. Now next part, or you can say the last one in how to improve your vocabulary, we have learning one word substitutes. How to get one word for a long sentence. Instead of using a long sentence, how to use one word in order to make it very easy for us to understand. Now learning of one word substitutes. What is a one word substitute? Replaces a group of words or phrases. One word can replace the whole group of words or the phrases. It can be changed into one word. We can comprise into single word and make it the whole meaning clear. It saves time while writing, even while speaking. While not only while writing, but it can definitely improves your language, as well as it will give you new words. You can learn many words and you use many words in your language. When you are using those words, you maybe don't realize that these are the one word substitutes. You got a habit, habitually you are using, but you don't know that these are the one word substitutes. Now from today onwards, understand that these are the one word substitutes. Like for example, audience, we use these words, we use or we have listened this word a lot of times in any of the comedy shows, to the, you can say, competition, competitive shows. You can know that the audience are listening, the vote of the audience matter. Audience, you have listened many times, but what is the audience? A number of people listening to a lecture or a concert or anything. Those who are listening, audible, with the listening, it is audience. The ones who are watching anything or those who are seeing are the spectators. They are watching, they are looking, they are seeing that. That is the spectators. They could be present at that time. There are so many spectators surrounded the accident scene. Many spectators would be there among those criminals. Like, so to watch the criminals, many spectators were also there. So it is present, like they are watching now, they are seeing now, they are present in front. That is the spectators. But when you are not in front, when you are either when you are front, but you are only listening more, you are not participating into that, you are not like anywhere, maybe you are a third person for that, then you could be called as the audience. Okay. Number of people listening to a lecture of concert. Instead of saying like we have 100 people who are listening our concert, we can say we have 100 audience. Okay. Next is pandemic. I hope you can relate it very easily. Pandemic. Now going on. why this video being made for you? Because of this pandemic. Pandemic, actually one word was there, endemic. Endemic means which can be a disease which can be prevalent in any one place, one area, that is endemic. But when it is prevalent over all the world and over in many countries or in a complete total one country would get affected, and it is pandemic. Here corona is a pandemic because overall world is getting affected, got affected. The economies are completely thrashed. Many of the things have been happened because of the pandemic. Many people lost their lives. So this pandemic prevalent over a whole country or a world. Endemic, at a particular area or a place. Previously endemic used to happen when no medical facilities were there and all. So at a place, that like whole village get the endemic of plague or floods. Any of the natural calamities can come to a particular place. But now it happens that because we can able to travel and world has become a global village, like we reach to each other very easily because of the different means of transport. So it has like widely spread. Maybe it could be endemic, but now it has become a pandemic. So I hope you have understood very easily the meaning of pandemic. Now next is indelible. Indelible, the mark that cannot be erased easily. Like you must have heard about the elections. So those who are partners like going to cast their vote, they will get one mark on their finger, on their index finger, and that ink is known as indelible ink, which mark cannot be erased immediately, which cannot be immediately can be removed. So instead of saying that, we are using the ink which is permanent and which whose mark is not supposed to be erased immediately or quickly. We can say, we can use the word indelible. We are using indelible ink during elections. Everybody can able to get that. Like many times I have used the word inquisitive during explanations. I think inquisitive means getting curious to wanted to know something more about that. That is, instead of saying you should be very curious to gain the knowledge and all, I could say be inquisitive. You should be inquisitive. That means the same thing. So instead of using the whole sentence, we can use single word. Like one more word I think I have used, atheist. Atheist, a person who never believes in God. If we remove A before that, if we make it theist, theist is the person who believes in God. Atheist, who never believes in God. So instead of saying that this person never believes in God and he never goes to the places of worship, we can say he is an atheist. He is a very pious person and he always go to the places of worship and he always keep his decisions or put all his decisions in hands of God and all. If you want to say about that, you can simply say this person is theist. So simple words, in this one words you will get lot of new words to be understood by you and your vocabulary definitely improves, and honestly speaking it impresses the other person. The person with whom you are speaking, they get to know that you have such a good vocabulary in that means you know so much about that language that it is very easily coming out of your mouth. Instead of whole sentences, simple words you are using and the other person is getting the meaning. So that could be things which you have to keep it in mind in order to improve your vocabulary. And there is a lot of practice being given in your study material as well as the reader. in the reader it becomes a little bit lengthier for you, but in study material in a very precise manner they have given all these, and very nicely being written. All you can solve it out very easily, and you can get it after the explanation. If you listen to the explanation carefully, you can understand the written material very easily and quickly. So in the next class we'll meet once again with the new grammar item. By the time, take care, have a nice day.